www.favecrafts.com presents. Bernadette's Gourd Creations. This time I will be showing you how to make this decoupaged bird feeder with a robin motif. So let's get started. You will need a clean dried gourd similar to this one. You can use a round, oval, or Martin House gourd. Tailor's tape and the template for the opening. I'll show you how to make your template later. Pencil, robin bird pattern, and scissors to cut it out. I'm not cutting out the apple blossom branch because I decided to freehand it. An assortment of handmade paper. Light fast markers or paint for detailing. I'm using Faber-Castell pit markers in green and black. Vintage handwriting on handmade paper. I scanned and printed it out from old letters. You can use stamps if you like. Outdoor Mod Podge and a brush. It can be very thick sometimes, so thin it out with some water. To cut it open, use a utility knife and a keyhole saw or a jigsaw. For hanging the gourd, a really interesting way would be using a washer. Or I found this in my grandpa's basement, so I'll be using this. Some wood glue to hold it in, and a drill bit for inserting the hanger as well as making drainage holes. Plus, of course, a drill gun. Lastly, outdoor sealer. Polyurethane yellows, but adds to the vintage charm, so I decided to use that. Here's a quick tip for making your doorway template. Measure the circumference of your gourd, divide that number by 6, and round it off to the nearest eighth inch. Use that number, mine came out to 4 inches, as the diameter of your template. Take a compass and make 2 overlapping circles as shown. First step, cutting open your bird feeder. Take your template and trace around it on your gourd, making sure to leave enough room at the base for the seed. For the placement of the other 2 doorways, run a line across the bottom by holding the pencil steady in one hand and turn the gourd around with the other. Each doorway will be spaced the same width apart as the diameter of your template. So I make a mark at 4 inches on mine. Yours are probably different. Then place the template right next to your mark and right above the mark of the bottom line, and then begin tracing around it. Do the same for the third doorway. To cut it open, make an incision into the gourd with a utility knife and begin sawing away with the tool of your choice. Second step, tear your background paper. Tear your background paper into manageable pieces by making a small tear and pulling away. Third step, time to decoupage. Pour some Mod Podge into an empty cup and add a bit of water until it runs like white glue. First, wet the gourd well. Then wet the back side of your paper. Place it on the gourd and then wet it again, making sure to push any air bubbles out and get rid of as many creases as you can. Fourth step, cut out, assemble, and decoupage your robin. Do the same decoupage technique with the robin motif. For the branches, I just freehanded a bunch of knobby and chunky limbs. Fifth step, clean edges with a utility knife. Seal edges with decoupage afterwards. Sixth step, add details. An eye, legs, flower centers, and leaves. Seventh step, attaching hanger. Mark the width of your washer, drill two holes on either side, and cut open with saw. File edges, insert hanger, and glue in place. I wound up using cement rather than just wood glue. Glue your hanger in place. then cement it after it's dried. Put on about 3 coats of outdoor sealer, I'm using polyurethane, and then make sure to do about 3 drainage holes on the bottom. Brought to you by Bernadette's Gourd Creations and www.favecrafts.com.